Hey, my name is Gala. I'm a Google Data Studio expert, and today I would like to talk a bit about calculated fields. This is a template. I connected here just Google Analytics demo account that you can have access as well, if it is easy. And sometimes we need to create additional fields in our report. And let's see how to do it. I know two options. I can show you two options how to do it. You can do it on data source level or in the chart level. For example, let's check how to do it in the chart level. I created a simple table with page title, total users, and new users. For example, we want to see the difference between total users and new users, and let's say it will be return users. How can you do it? We can click here to add metric, click to create field, and let's say return users. We type a name of the field, and we can create a custom formula. In our case, will be total users minus new users. Here you can change type, number, currency, like some running calculation, comparison calculation, but we don't need it for now. Just see that you have these options, and we can click apply. Okay, you can see we have a column with return users, and this is the difference between total and new users. Here we created a field on a chart level. So now we can create the same field on the report level. How can we do it? We can go to resources, manage edit data sources. Okay, you can do like this and click edit, or you can click to this pencil, edit data source. And here we have all fields that this data source has. Here we have a button, add a field. Click here, let's return users report level. Let's call it like this, just we can recognize it, this field. And here as well, we can just type a formula, total users minus new users. And we save. Then we can go to all fields and no, we don't need to reconnect, just finished. And now when we can, when we created a new field on the data source level, we can add it here as a metric, add metric, return users, report level, default group. And the result is the same, number is the same. Number is the same. What's the difference? What's the difference? For example, we need to create a lot of elements with the same new metric. For example, I want to add a chart. I don't know, bar chart with the same information. It will be page title and users, total or new users. I don't like how does it look. Let's change for this one. It will be easier to read. It will be easier to read. Okay, new users, and I think we need, okay. Sorry. Okay, new users, and when we added return users as a chart on the chart level. We don't have this field in a new chart, so when we click new metric, return, we don't see return users field because it applies only for this table. But the field return users report level, we can find it here, and it is nice when you have when you have a lot of charts with the same new metric, with the same additional metric, it is nice to create it in a report level, because we already we don't need to create this field again. We just can add it from our fields library. It is one case, but could be another case. For example, we want to copy this report or for example we want to connect the other data source, copy this report and connect as a Google Analytics account. Let's see how it will work when we copy report. We can click make a copy. Yes, I will keep this. I'm not sure if I can show you this field. I think in this case it will work. Yeah, it will work. Okay, sorry. The point is, when we connect as a data source, and we have to create these report level metrics again, so it will not appear automatically for new Google Analytics account. If we connect new Google Analytics account, we have to recreate all calculated metrics from the scratch, but on the chart level, calculated metrics will be the same, and you can keep it, and it will work. They will work. So the point is, when you have one report with a lot of charts with the same calculated metrics, use it on the report level. When you know that you will copy this report and apply for different accounts, use calculated metrics on the table level. It will save time for your work. So this is it about calculated metrics, and I can show you that we can use these calculated fields for dimensions as well. For example, let's do this. We have page title and we want to find some categories from page titles or languages. I think in this case it will be nice to have categories. We can click add dimension, create a field. We can call it category, and let's use the formula case when contains text page title. When page title contains sale, for example, let's use sale. When contains text page title contains lifestyle, category will be lifestyle. When page title contains, what do we have here? Apparel. Then else, no. Okay, and we will apply the formula. I wanted to show you that calculated fields could work with metrics and with dimensions as well. And we wrote formula that separate some words from sale. I mean, not separate words. This formula taking page title, and if we find this word in the title, we will select it, split it for the special category. And yeah, we have special categories. And if we remove page title, we can see users by our categories. So I think that is it, what I wanted to tell you now. Let me know if you want to have more information about these calculated formulas. It is a really interesting thing, and you can do a lot of different stuff. And that is it for today. Hope you like it, and see you soon.